This is a three-dimensional diagram of the refrigeration cycle. The vapor compression cycle consists of a compressor, condenser, capillary tube, and the evaporator or the cooling coil. Before understanding the vapor compression cycle, some important concepts of heat need to be grasped. The following are the three concepts on which the vapor compression cycle works. Concept number one. Heat flows from high temperature to low temperature. Concept number two. If the pressure increases, the temperature also increases. And concept number three. Lowering the pressure lowers the boiling temperature. As the compressor is switched on, it begins to compress the refrigerant and converts the low pressure vapors into high pressure vapors. And as per the concept number two discussed earlier, as the compressor compresses the refrigerant, the temperature of these high pressure vapors also increases. These high pressure, high temperature refrigerant vapors from the compressor are passed into the condenser. In the condenser, the high pressure, high temperature vapors give out heat into the atmosphere and cool down into a high pressure refrigerant liquid. The temperature of this high pressure liquid is 15 degrees more approximately than the ambient temperature. This high pressure liquid refrigerant then enters and passes through the capillary. The pressure of this liquid refrigerant drops while passing through the capillary, and this high pressure liquid refrigerant becomes low pressure liquid refrigerant. This low pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant now enters the cooling coil or the evaporator. In the evaporator, the low pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant absorbs heat from the enclosed area. Thus cooling the enclosed area and convert into a vapor state. These vapors then enter into the compressor where they are compressed into high pressure refrigerant vapors. And the cycle goes on.